that have been taking all over the earth. Thank you so much. You are welcome. Bring the people who are coming to the front, please. Ushers, don't look there. People, look at me. Focus on me, beloved. There is enough ushers there. Don't worry. Sit down, beloved. Sit down with your notebook. Just make sure you bring them quickly. They sit down because they have not lost anything. So listen to this now. The Lord began to do things regarding these three prophets around this ministry. Tremendous things they are happening until this day. About these three prophets are happening in this ministry. But look at this now. One of them is this conversation I want to share here. He began to show me the dreams and visions of Daniel. I think I've seen almost across them. I don't know whether there's any more left. But he has shown me a lot of the majority of them. And one of them is this. Let me describe very quickly. One time, in a tremendous vision, I just realized there was a very huge, humongous, historic and shocking statue standing before me. And I could see its feet of clay and iron. What huge, unbelievable. So even to see it alone shocked me. And this conversation I'm sharing, 2 days ago I was on radio. In fact, in the morning before I went to the airport, I was on radio. Again that night he showed me this. Recently, those who are plugged in, you know. Yeah, so twice, I'm shocked he has repeated. When I was coming here, he has repeated twice. Yeah, rather, he has repeated it once. He has shown me twice. Look at this now. This statue was so big, so huge, that looking at it alone, in that vision, actually shocked me. I was a little bit so shocked at this. Because I asked, what is this? However, then, in that vision, let me give the specific. In that vision, from this direction here, while inside there, and not like this, but came like this. Came a rock. In fact, that rock, I can even draw it. It has a sharp edge. It's a rock. It's a rock, but with a sharp edge. Did not come like this. Actually, came slanting like this. A rock came from that side where the Lord was. I knew the Lord was there. And that rock smashed that statue until what happened recently happened again. Recently, when he repeated it, the dust, it became like chaff. It disintegrated. And the dust, the Lord made the dust sweep me. The dust of that statue sweep me. So I could feel the dust. Follow me on this now. So, the statue, humongous, unbelievable, made of different metals, and then smashed like this, and the dust even blows on me. And then after that, as I was standing in... That was then, when the Lord showed it to me in 2004, I thought it was the ocean. Because all of a sudden, that rock that smashed became a huge mountain, and I found that I did not have where to stand. I thought I was, because it was light blue, bluish down there, I thought it was an ocean. I thought I was going to fall into the ocean. It looked like an ocean then. Now I'm wiser. Filled the whole earth, I did not have where to put my feet. I thought I was going to fall like this into the ocean. Only when I went now into the Bible is when I realized, no, that was actually the universe, the other side, not the ocean. And that conversation he had with Daniel is in the book of Daniel chapter 2, verses 34, 35. Then you hear the conversation, the dream. And then the interpretation is verses, the same chapter 2, verses 44, 45, but I'm going to summarize it for you here because that is not, it is part of the conversation we're having today, but it's not the thought that will anchor our talk today. The message of the Lord to this nation. He's saying that at that time, the God of heaven will establish forth a kingdom. And he says, and that kingdom will not be left to any other people again. That rock, that small rock that came and smashed, that kingdom, that the mountain built was the kingdom of God, the symbolism of the kingdom of God, that rock smashing the statue would create, would build, establish, install, that totally covers the entire earth. So really relevant to our discussion today. The kingdom of God, the coming kingdom of God. But look at this now, there's finer detail to that. Meaning, you see a rock cut out but not by human hands. Meaning, in the establishing of the kingdom of God, there will not be a human hand. Hallelujah. I know he has sent us, he has called us to do these things here, to come and trumpet this for him, to be his mouthpiece, to pastor that church, whatever. But the kingdom of God has its owner. And whenever a pastor in Namibia and Windhoek is given the opportunity, I call it the privilege, the humbling privilege, to pastor a church, then it is as such. It is that. It is a privilege. So it is not your church. I know there is a bit of misunderstanding. I'm going to come to the church in Namibia. As you can tell, I have so much knowledge. He has shown me everything in the church. I'm going to come to that. But let me just clear this. See, a rock cut out, but not by human hands. We are simply servants within that kingdom. That kingdom. I know you like to say we are kings within a kingdom. Okay, whichever thing you say. But I want to submit unto you that we are servants in that kingdom. And he's saying, we will simply operate under the command and the instruction and under the paradigm set up by God. So it will not be built of human nature. So if you were me, that is the point at which to ask the church in Namibia, then what is the human hand doing in the church in Namibia? If you were me, that's the question you can ask there in passing. In passing, as I pass. Because that's not our topic of discussion today. That is not the message I brought you. But yes, it is. By bearing, I was running through. It is. He's saying, then what is the humanness doing in the glorious eternal kingdom of God that is in the church? Then what is the pride doing at the pulpit where you feel you are the one building it for God? Eh? You feel really it is you. God has to depend on. Oh. Remember, there are 7,000 who have not yet done what? And worship God. Always remember that. Always remember that God can shock you. That's why for me, my instruction, the brief that sent me is very clear. To say it as has been said by him, as it is. When it hurts you, the better. That means it's working. Hallelujah. Because if it does not hurt you, when the church is in this condition I see in Namibia here, then there is a problem. You need to go back to the Lord and ask for the message. A privilege, he says. It's privilege. It's humbling to be told. That's why I started by saying, it is so humbling, a privilege, to be sent to you. Because these are matters of eternity that are unpurchasable. Unpurchasable. You cannot buy with money. Yeah, these are serious issues of the Creator. So this is not the message for the day. Can I run through them because of time? But you can see already, he's saying that there is a kingdom that is coming. That's why I am here. And he says, repent and prepare the way, for the kingdom of God is in hand. And he says, that kingdom will last forever and ever, has no end. So, even as you like to make profit, to be profitable in Namibia here, the things you do, you want to prosper, you want to grow in it, you want to profit in it. So he's saying, this is the most profitable thing to do, to prepare for that eternal kingdom now, with your 70 years here. It's profitable. It is worthy to spend the short time we have to prepare for that eternal one. We will benefit bigger by preparing for that which does not end. Because the running around barbecue here, discos, what, drinking alcohol, whatever, that is short-lived like this. In fact, people, those who are wise, they will almost feel sorry for you. So, no, but this is so short-lived. Why would you invest in that? And destructive. He said, there is a kingdom that is coming. And that's why I am here. It is called the kingdom of God. And he says, will not be left to any other people. It is for those who walk in that way. The people of the Lord. Hallelujah. So there is so much there. It's a whole message on its own accord. But I just wanted you to know that the Lord spoke. He spoke in 2004. He spoke recently on 17th. 17th of this month. In fact, I am giving you hot bread from the throne of my Father. Recently he spoke it. So really, it is important to him. I don't know why when I'm coming to Namibia and then he speaks it. So sometimes I also want to understand deeper things. You understand? As I'm about to leave to airport, actually you are waiting for me outside, right? To come, so we go to the airport. Then you are shocked I'm on live on radio, right? So some of these things, you may want to understand deeper why. Is he saying, go right there and announce the coming of the kingdom of God from Windhoek? What is the message then? But we know the instruction that we need to prepare. The nations need to prepare. And we know how to prepare. I'm going to give deeper instruction here. However, we know that for without holiness, nobody will see the Lord. You see that? So really, God is so good, he put everything in the Bible for us. We can literally prepare and make substantive gain and enter. And as a pastor, how do you then prepare as a pastor? How do you prepare the sheep when you yourself, you have not yet entered? So really, the first call is at the pulpit, right? So that you can now lead them to that which you've entered in, that which you know, right? Hallelujah. And that's why for me this is a big blessing, because this is a big crowd.